हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 3 फाइबर टू फैब्रिक. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज प्रोसेसिंग फाइबर्स इनटू वूल. द वूल व्हिच इज यूज फॉर निटिंग स्वेटर्स और फॉर वीविंग शॉल्स इज द फिनिश्ड प्रोडक्ट ऑफ अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस व्हिच इन्वॉल्व्स द फॉलोइंग स्टेप्स. नाउ there is a long process before the sweaters we knit or shawls we weave using the wool to become ready to use. So this process involves the following steps. Step 1. The fleece of the sheep along with a thin layer of skin is removed from its body. This process is called shearing. Machines similar to those used by barbers are used to shave off their hair. Usually, hair is removed during the hot weather. This enables sheep to survive without their protective coat of hair. Now, in step 1, the hair of sheep is removed along with a thin layer of skin from its body. And this process is called shearing. The machines which are similar to the machines used for shaving the hair of humans by barbers are used to remove the fleece of sheep. To enable sheep to survive without their hair, which is their protective coat, hair are removed during hot weather. The hair provide woolen fibers. Woolen fibers are then processed to obtain woolen yarn. Shearing does not hurt the sheep, just as it does not hurt when you get a haircut or your father shaves his beard. Do you know why? The uppermost layer of the skin is dead. Also, the hair of sheep grow again just as your hair does. Now, the woolen fibers we get from the hair are processed to obtain woolen yarn. This process does not hurt the sheep. Which process? Shearing. Shearing does not hurt the sheep as it is just as cutting our hair. Do you know why it does not hurt us or sheep? Because the uppermost layer of skin is dead. So, it does not hurt when our hair is cut or a sheep is sheared because the uppermost layer of the skin is dead. Similarly, just like us, the hair of sheep grow again. In this picture, you can see how sheep are sheared. Shearing of the sheep is shown in this picture. Step 2. The sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove grease, dust and dirt. This is called scouring. Nowadays, scouring is done by machines. The next step is scouring, in which the sheared skin with hair is thoroughly washed in tanks in order to remove grease, dust and dirt. Nowadays, it is done by machines. Step 3. After scouring, sorting is done. The hairy skin is sent to a factory where hair of different textures are separated or sorted. Now in the next step, which is the third step, sorting is done by sending the hairy skin to a factory. What happens in the factory? Here the hair are separated depending on different textures of the hair or the hair is sorted. So the next step, that is the third step, is sorting. Step 4. The small fluffy fibers called burrs are picked from the hair. These are the same burrs which sometimes appear on your sweaters. The fibers are scoured again and dried. This is the wool ready to be drawn into fibers. In step 4, burrs, which are small fluffy fibers, are picked out from the hair. Now these are the burrs which sometimes appear on our sweaters. Then the fibers are scoured again and dried. After that, the wool is ready to be drawn into fibers. Step 5. The fibers can be dyed in various colors, as the natural fleece of sheep and goat is black, brown or white. The natural color of the fleece of sheep or goat is black, brown or white. ये जो hair होते हैं sheep के, उनके natural colors आपको भी पता होंगे, वो या तो black, brown और white होते हैं. So they can be dyed, यानी कि उनमें color कर सकते हैं. they can be dyed in various colors. Next step, step 6, which is the last step. The fibers are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn. The longer fibers are made into wool for sweaters and the shorter fibers are spun and woven into woolen cloth. Now in the last step, rolling of wool is done. The fiber for wool are straightened, combed and rolled into yarn. What are they done? They are straightened. Unko straight karte hain, comb karte hain and they are rolled into yarn. The fibers which are longer are made into wool for sweaters and the fibers which are shorter are spun and woven into woolen cloth. Let us now discuss occupational hazard. Wool industry is an important means of livelihood for many people in our country. But sorters' job is risky as sometimes they get infected by a bacterium anthrax, which causes a fatal blood disease called sorter's disease. Such risks faced by workers in any industry are called occupational hazards. In this paragraph, it is said that in some industries like wool industry, the workers have to face risks of getting diseases and sometimes death. These are called occupational hazards. Here, hazard means danger or risk. Now, such an occupational hazard is the sorter's disease. The people who sort the wool can get infected by bacteria called anthrax. This bacterium infects the blood of the person, which lead to fatal, that is death. So there are such risks in any industry and these risks are called occupational hazards. The next topic we are going to discuss is silk. Silk fibers are also animal fibers. Silkworms spin the silk fibers. The rearing of silkworm for obtaining silk is called sericulture. Find out from your mother, aunt or grandmother the kind of silk saris they have. List the kinds of silk. Before we discuss the process of obtaining the silk, it is necessary to know the interesting life history of the silk moth. Now, apart from wool, the other animal fiber we use are silk fibers. Silk fibers are obtained from silkworms or silk moths as they spin silk fibers. For obtaining silk fiber, silkworms are reared and this process is called sericulture. We will discuss about the process of obtaining silk, but before that, let us know the life history of a silk moth, which is very interesting. The female silk moth lays eggs from which hatch larvae, which are called caterpillars or silkworms. They grow in size and when the caterpillar is ready to enter the next stage of its life history called pupa, it first weaves a net to hold itself. Then it swings its head from side to side in the form of the figure of 8. During these movements of the head, the caterpillar secretes a fiber made of a protein which hardens on exposure to air and becomes silk fiber. Soon, the caterpillar completely covers itself by silk fibers. This covering is known as the cocoon. The further development of the moth continues inside the cocoon. Silk fibers are used for weaving silk cloth. Can you imagine that the soft silk yarn is as strong as a comparable thread of steel? When the eggs of the silk moth hatch, larvae are produced called caterpillars or silkworms. They then eat leaves and grow in size. And then they enter the next stage of the caterpillar's life called pupa. To enter this stage, the caterpillar weaves a net that can hold it. The caterpillar then swings its head in the shape of 8. As it swings its head, fiber is secreted. This fiber is made up of protein and as it comes in contact with air, it hardens and forms the silk fiber. The caterpillar then covers itself into silk and turns into pupa. The covering of the caterpillar is called cocoon. द कैटरपिलर कन्वर्ट्स इटसेल्फ इनटू अ सिल्क मॉथ इनसाइड द कवरिंग. सिल्क फाइबर वी गेट फ्रॉम द ककून इज यूज फॉर वीविंग सिल्क क्लॉथ. इवन दो द सिल्क यार्न इज सॉफ्ट, इट इज एज स्ट्रॉन्ग एज अ थ्रेड ऑफ स्टील. द सिल्क यार्न और थ्रेड इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द ककून ऑफ द सिल्क मॉथ. There is a variety of silk moths which look very different from one another, and the silk yarn they yield is different in texture, coarse, smooth, shiny, etc. Thus, tassar silk, muga silk, kosa silk, etc. are obtained from cocoons spun by different types of moths. The most common silk moth is the mulberry silk moth. The silk fiber from the cocoon of this moth is soft, lustrous and elastic and can be dyed in beautiful colors. Sericulture or culture of silkworms is a very old occupation in India. India produces plenty of silk on a commercial scale. The silk thread or the silk yarn is obtained from the cocoon. ये जो silk thread है या फिर जो silk yarn है वो हमें कहाँ से मिलता है? Cocoon से मिलता है. Cocoon जो है वो जो caterpillar है उसकी covering को हम cocoon बोलते हैं, और we get the silk thread from the cocoon. Now there are different types of silk obtained because of different types of silk moths. The different texture of the silk include coarse, smooth and shiny texture. Coarse means rough. There are silk having rough texture, there are silk having smooth texture and shiny texture. So depending on their textures, we have tassar silk, muga silk, kosa silk, etc. and they are obtained from different type of moths. Now the most common, a very well known silk moth is the mulberry silk moth, and the speciality, the quality of the silk we obtain from this moth is it is very soft and lustrous. Lustrous means it is a very shining silk and elastic, and it can be dyed, it can be colored in beautiful colors. Culture of silkworms known as sericulture is a very old occupation in India. India produces plenty of silk commercially.